Astral Materials, based in Mountain View, California, was founded in 2023 as Astral Forge and renamed in 2024. The company emerged from a team of experts in microgravity materials and hardware design, with plans to manufacture higher purity semiconductor materials that can be made on Earth. Astral views microgravity as humanity's next pivotal manufacturing tool, enabling defect-free materials that advance existing technologies and inspire new ones. CEO and co-founder Jessica Frick leads the company as a global expert in microgravity crystal growth, spanning semiconductors to metal organic frameworks. With over a decade of experience designing and building crystal growth hardware, including microgravity systems, she draws from her research at Stanford University. The company's proprietary microgravity furnace yields ultra-high quality crystals that unblock bottlenecks in advanced applications. Chief Technology Officer Gia Janowitz, prior to his position at Astral Materials, spearheaded the development of multiple automated science payloads that reach the International Space Station. He's an expert with hardware design and materials manufacturing. The advantages of manufacturing materials in space. Manufacturing materials in space offers three key advantages. First, removing the effects of gravity. In orbit, gravity appears to be almost completely eliminated. In reality, the gravitational force is still experienced. It's just offset by the spacecraft horizontal velocity. There are still some residual forces such as atmospheric drag, solar pressure, and onboard vibrations, but the effective gravity is reduced to about 1/1,000,000th of Earth's gravity. Materials inside the spacecraft no longer experience natural convection, hydrostatic pressure, buoyancy, or container interactions, all of which harm crystal growth. Poor quality crystals limit semiconductor device lifespan and performance, especially in quantum computing and high-power applications. These devices cannot scale the high-quality semiconductors required and can only be manufactured in low quantities. Second, Earth-based fixes for crystal defects demand high costs and energy, but only reduce rather than eliminate the problems. Astral Materials addresses the root problem by moving the crystal growth stage into space, eliminating the cause of defects, and producing consistent high-quality crystals that are impossible to produce on Earth. The impact could be enormous. Semiconductors are the foundation on which modern technology is built. No piece of advanced technology works without semiconductors. The performance of a device is only as strong as its weakest link. Ultra-pure semiconductors will allow more high-power devices, more compact and longer-lasting devices that require less maintenance, which ultimately, at sufficient scale, drives down costs. Crystal growth furnace, the key piece of technology. Astral plans to manufacture semiconductor material with a mini fridge-sized furnace that reaches temperatures of above 1,500 degrees Celsius, that's 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit. This crystal growth furnace, as it's called, is a specialized piece of equipment designed for manufacturing advanced semiconductors in the microgravity environment of low Earth orbit. It takes advantage of the absence of gravity-induced convection and sedimentation to produce higher quality crystals than possible on Earth, targeting materials such as gallium nitride and silicon. The temperature of the furnace needs to be high to efficiently produce these semiconductor materials. For silicon processing, the temperature must be at least 1,420 degrees Celsius and 1,500 degrees Celsius for broad applications. The size and design of the furnace must be compact to fit into a re-entry capsule or space vehicle. It includes an arc melting system, real-time monitoring via sensors and cameras, and mechanisms to contain molten materials at fixed points. Astral is focusing on the production of gallium nitride, a next-generation semiconductor offering superior power efficiency and thermal tolerance compared to silicon. Additional work will include high-quality silicon crystals for analysis before deciding on commercial production. Partnership with Sierra Space. In December 2024, Sierra Space announced agreements with Astral Materials and Space Forge to explore using its Dream Chaser vehicle and space station technology for microgravity manufacturing. Jessica Frick, Astral's CEO, said about this agreement, "This partnership with Sierra Space is a fantastic opportunity that allows us to focus on our strength, microgravity crystal growth," unquote. Under the agreement, Astral Materials will work with Sierra Space on designing projects that could be flown on Sierra Space's Dream Chaser vehicle. The agreement could also include cooperation on how to incorporate semiconductor manufacturing technologies into systems Sierra Space is developing for commercial space stations. NASA partners with Astral Materials for parabolic flight tests. NASA has selected Astral Materials to conduct parabolic flight tests to validate a crystal growth furnace for semiconductor manufacturing in space. Funded by a NASA Small Business Innovation Research Ignite Phase 2 contract, this effort supports the Chips for America initiative, a government initiative aimed at improving domestic semiconductor manufacturing. Astral Materials will test its furnace design to ensure its cooling system works. The furnace must heat silicon to at least 1,420 degrees Celsius for short durations in microgravity, producing spherical silicon samples. It's not expected that these experiments will produce higher quality materials, but instead verify the hardware works as expected under microgravity conditions. NASA and Astral will be looking at a few key metrics, including furnace operability, repeatability, and the link between gravitational conditions and crystal formation. NASA will independently analyze pre- and post-flight silicon samples to measure material improvements. Astral Materials and SpaceWorks win NASA TechLeap Prize. In July 2025, that's a week ago at the time of recording of this video, SpaceWorks Enterprises, in partnership with Astral Materials, secured NASA's TechLeap Prize, Space Technology Payload Challenge. Their project, High Cadence Microgravity Silicon Semiconductor Crystal Manufacturing, merges SpaceWorks' re-entry expertise with Astral Materials' in-space semiconductor production. The initiative targets a 2026 demo mission on a NASA-assigned orbital platform that will demonstrate in-space manufacturing and product return via SpaceWorks' re-entry device capsule, or RED capsule for short. SpaceWorks' RED capsule has undergone extensive ground testing, multiple high-altitude drop test campaigns, and a 2017 flight to the International Space Station. Dr. Jessica Frick, CEO and co-founder of Astral, said about this prize award, "To close the business case of in-space manufacturing, it is critical not only to accomplish on-orbit processing, but to demonstrate high-cadence, on-demand product return capabilities. This mission with SpaceWorks is the first step towards that goal," unquote. In addition, Astral won a NASA Ignite Phase 2 award to develop its crystal growth furnace for low Earth orbit with terrestrial uses as well. The award is worth up to $850,000. Competitors. The space manufacturing field is becoming more crowded each year. Space Forge, for instance, is also involved in manufacturing superalloys and semiconductors in space, making them a direct competitor to Astral Materials. Both companies have partnered with Sierra Space and their Dream Chaser vehicle for microgravity missions. Varda Space, a startup I've covered on this channel previously, also manufacture in space, but they are focused, at least for now, on pharmaceutical drugs rather than semiconductors. Other startups like Redwire provide in-space manufacturing services using the International Space Station. Atmos Space Cargo, a German space startup, are working on re-entry capsules that can return in-space manufactured goods back to Earth. The company recently launched a tech demo on a SpaceX transporter mission. Atmos and Varda complement Astral Materials, as their platforms could host its crystal growth hardware. SpaceForge, however, competes directly. Still, many companies, governments, and agencies would benefit from ultra-pure semiconductors, so there is no problem with direct competitors at this time. In fact, any success for SpaceForge will prove the business case for manufacturing in space and likely lead to increased investor interest in the sector. Upcoming events. In November 2025, more parabolic flights from Astral Materials, funded by NASA, will take place. The flight campaign is part of ongoing efforts to refine in-space manufacturing techniques. In 2026, Astral will launch its first orbital demonstration of semiconductor crystal manufacturing. NASA partially funds this mission, which uses an orbital transfer vehicle to host a payload. SpaceWorks RED-25 re-entry capsule will carry the payload for 3 to 12 months before returning the manufactured materials to Earth. Success could lead to materials that could be sold to offset the cost of the mission and to validate the business plan, which could in turn help with raising funds for new missions and technology development. Ongoing joint efforts with Sierra Space on using their Dream Chaser vehicle for hosting payloads. Dream Chaser hasn't flown yet, but is due to make its first flight this year. Potentially, Vast Space Haven 1 could host a payload from Astral Materials. A number of payload slots are still available before its planned launch in May 2026. What are your thoughts on manufacturing ultra-pure materials in space? Can it scale to commercially viable levels? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space news video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.